Well, we can tell you that the fight broke out yesterday at lunchtime. It was actually in the courtyard, and it started with just two students. Those students were taken to the office by the school resource officer, but still in the courtyard, several hundred students, and apparently they kind of had gathered, so administrators decided the best thing to do was ask them to all go back to class. They were asked to do that, but three of them chose not to, one in particular really going after that school resource officer.
Actually had been told several times by administrators and three times by the officer to go back to class. The student cursed the officer, and then he got into an aggressive fighting stance, and that's when the officer used his taser.
What started the fight is still really not known, but police do admit there are active gangs at that school.
That's been a big problem we've been dealing with, gang activity, graffiti, basically attempts at intimidation against the school staff and against our SRO who's out there.
Lieutenant Ken Gamble, who supervises this particular school resource officer, says the officer acted appropriately.
When you have a kid get into an aggressive fighting stance after cursing the officer, that is when we step up the force.
Several parents we talked with Wednesday afternoon were not even aware of what happened, but one mother said she felt like the police handled the situation well.
The impression yesterday when I received my phone call from the principal that everything was okay, Kernersville police handled it, and that things were good, and my son said he was okay yesterday.
Now, we do want to tell you that the principal did make that phone call to all the parents and guardians to let them know what had happened, and five students have been charged so far in this. In the first fight between those two students, one of those students has been charged with a fray. The other student has not been charged with anything yet. And then in that big group incident, the student who was tased has been charged with disorderly conduct and delaying a police officer. He's a juvenile. And two other juveniles also charged with obstructing a police officer. And then while all this was going on, another student came out into the hall with the hall pass, tried to get involved in the situation. That student also is charged with resisting an officer. I'm Kathy Cheek, live at East Forsyth High School.